In the last video, we were looking at the matrix which will take us from one orientation of a rigid body to another one. Okay, so if, for example, at time t equal to 0, the body is oriented in some way, and at a later time t, it's oriented in a different way, we found out what matrix will take us from first orientation to the second one. And just remind you that we were taking one of the points in the rigid body to be fixed. Okay. Now I'll tell you of about a very interesting, nice, actually, really nice theorem by Euler, which concerns again the orientations of rigid body with one point fixed. So let me emphasize that by putting here with a fixed point. Okay. Now, what's the theorem? The theorem is the following. It says that no matter what you do to arrive at a final orientation of the rigid body. So you start at some in some initial configuration, you do certain things, or you maybe do repeatedly several different kinds of motions, and you finally arrive at some orientation of your rigid body. That configuration can be arrived at by one single rotation, by one simple rotation about an axis. That's the theorem, okay? Meaning, you will be able to find a line which will be passing through the fixed point about which, if you do a single rotation by some amount theta, you will arrive at the final configuration of the rigid body. Okay? So here, let me say what I'm saying. Okay, that's your rigid body. That's the point which always remains fixed, the point O. Now, this is at time t equal to 0. And something else happens at later time, okay? It looks very different at a later time. Okay, right now, it may look different because I have not deformed the body. It's just I'm because this body can rotate about this point, so it may look different from different angles. So let's say this is looking like this. So the theorem says that you will be able to find an axis, you will be able to find a line that goes through this point O. Okay. About which, when you do a rotation by some angle theta, this is not let's say capital phi. Okay, about an angle phi, and you will arrive from this orientation to that orientation. Okay, now let's quickly see whether this appears to be reasonable, that this can happen indeed, by first looking at the degrees of freedom. Okay. Now you know that there are only 3 degrees of freedom for the rigid body with one point fixed. These are the 3 Euler angles. Now if I'm saying that all you need to tell me is one axis and an angle and I will be able to arrive in that final configuration, then this angle together with the axis should use up the 3 degrees of freedom, right? Because this will be equivalent to that thing. And of course, this counts up, adds up to 3, because phi, this angle phi is one number. So you use up 1 degree of freedom in this. Then your axis, specifying an axis requires knowing 2 numbers. Okay, so if I tell you that there is a line going from this point O and tell me where it is, you will ask me what are, for example, the polar and azimuthal angles of this line. Okay, so that is why azimuthal, that is why we have two here angles. So if I tell you the polar and azimuthal angles, you will know where that line is. So clearly 2 plus 1 equals to 3, so it's it will be consistent with what we know already about the degrees of freedom. And let's try to prove this theorem. So I'll prove it by utilizing some properties of matrices. But you can see for different proofs given in, for example, Whittaker, this is a treatise on analytical dynamics, and also there is a treatise by Parse. They will give you geometrical proofs as well. And in fact, they will give you more than one proof. So let's proceed with proof. Okay. So if indeed this theorem is true, then I should be able to find a line which does not change upon any transformation of the body, right? And that line would be the line about which the rotation will happen. The rotation meaning this rotation, which Euler's theorem is saying that you can do a rotation and arrive at that angle theta, arrive at the new configuration. Okay. Before we proceed with the proof, I will ask you to do one or two exercises. Let's go back to this matrix which you saw in the last video. You see, this is made up of these three matrices, each of which is an orthogonal matrix, right? These all are, this one is orthogonal, and they all are orthogonal matrices, and moreover their determinants are equal to 1. So what you do is now prove. Okay, where, what did I do? Okay, let us remove this. So prove, this is exercise for you, that if you multiply A, B and C, and if A, B and C are orthogonal matrices, then this product is also orthogonal. If A, B and C are orthogonal. Also prove that if determinant of A, also prove that determinant of A times B times C is unity if determinant of A, determinant of B and determinant of C, they are all equal and they are equal to 1, which would prove for you that this product ABC is an orthogonal matrix with determinant 1. Okay, which is equivalent to saying that this matrix. Okay, so basically you will end up proving that A is orthogonal, meaning A transpose is A, and also that determinant of A is 1. That is what that exercise would amount to. Okay, that's good. Now, if I want to prove Euler's theorem, I should prove that there is one line which will remain unchanged under the transformation. And that line will of course be the axis of rotation. Okay, equivalently, if you will be able to find a plane in the rigid body that upon that I mean, all the points in that plane will still remain in the plane, in the same plane after the transformation happens. And clearly that plane is perpendicular to the axis of rotation, right? Because all the points in that plane will just go about that axis. So they will not move out of that plane. Okay, so how do we prove this theorem? If I could show that one of the eigenvalues of this matrix A, is unity, then I would have proved the theorem, because that would imply that there exists a vector which will not change, right? Let's see. So what I want to do is, I want to prove that one of the eigenvalues of the matrix A, which is an orthogonal matrix. So actually it is more generally true that eigenvalues of an of an orthogonal matrix is unity. Right? Okay, meaning if I take a vector X and I have my matrix capital A, which you have seen, then I should be able to show that one of the lambdas is 1. If I do that, then this X will give me the direction of the axis of rotation. Okay, now this is a general property of an orthogonal matrix, which we will anyway prove now. And the proof is simple. I will utilize two results to prove this, and they are the following. So first I will show that if you take the determinant of 1 minus A transpose, this is same as determinant of A minus 1. Okay, I'll prove these two results shortly. And the second result is, if you take the determinant of 1 minus A transpose, the same thing as here, then you get determinant of 1 minus A. This one is unity matrix. Okay, this is unity matrix. That is also a unit matrix. Okay, you see these are related by an overall minus sign, and you already know that this will be minus 1 times determinant of A minus 1, and it will be cube here because these are 3 cross 3 matrices. If A was a n cross n matrix, you would have got, instead of 3, n here. So in this case, this is true, which is minus, because minus 1 cube is minus 1, determinant of A minus 1. Okay, so this equals determinant of A minus 1. And the same thing equals minus determinant of A minus 1. The only possibility is that determinant of 1 minus A transpose should vanish. Okay, if this vanishes, then only the results 1 and result 2 will be consistent. But then you realize that this is nothing but the characteristic equation for minor correction. So what we what I wanted to say was, this means that determinant of A minus 1 and minus determinant of A minus 1, they are equal, which means that determinant of A minus 1 is 0. Okay, and this is the characteristic equation. Right? So if you were, for example, looking at the eigenvalue problem, you would have written out determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. Right, that's how you will go on searching for lambda and the eigenvectors. Now here what we see is that this is true, which means one of the solutions is lambda equal to 1. And what does that mean? It means that this is true with lambda equal to 1. Equivalently, one vector will remain unchanged under this transformation, which implies that that transformation is a rotation about that axis. Right? So this is the proof of Euler's theorem. And I can make some further remark using Euler's theorem, and it is the following. So imagine at time t equal to 0, your body is oriented in a certain fashion and it is continuously moving. Okay, imagine for example a rock in free space. Okay, one of these big rocks which is just moving in under gravity, influence of gravity in deep space. Okay, think of it some time t equal to 0 at which you start looking at it. At the next moment it is not in the same, it is not oriented similarly, it is doing some motion. Okay, for now let's ignore the translation part. Then from what we have proved here, we can say that the orientation at the next moment of that rock can be arrived at by a rotation about some axis. Okay, so you can think of it as rotating about an axis at that instant. But next instant, you can say it is rotating about another axis. There's no reason why this axis and that axis have to be the same, right? Because it is tumbling in a very complicated way. So you see, at every instant, you will be able to find an axis about which this entire rock is rotating. And we speak of instantaneous axis of rotation. INS. Instantaneous axis of rotation. Okay, so from our Euler's theorem, we have been able to say that there is an axis of rotation about which the body is rotating, and at each instant, this axis will keep changing. Okay, so at one time it will be going in some direction, at the next moment that axis will be oriented along a different direction. Okay, and all the points on the axis of rotation will not be moving at that moment. Okay, so that's the Euler's theorem. We'll talk more about rigid body dynamics in the following videos. Okay, see you.